السلام عليكم and welcome back to Pure Pathways. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي بسم الله. Welcome back to our Ramadan stories. Today's story will be Abu Bakr's secret. So what comes to your mind when you hear the word secret? Probably something bad, right? Something that you wouldn't want anyone to know about? Something that would bring you embarrassment or maybe even shame? Usually those are the kinds of things that people try to keep hidden. But did it ever occur to you to keep something good a secret? You'd probably want everyone to know about the great things you've done, but I'm here to tell you that sometimes keeping the good things to yourself can bring you even more reward than exposing them in front of others. Today's lesson, Abu Bakr's secret. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu was the Prophet ﷺ's closest and dearest friend who was by his side during every major event of his life. He was one of the best men to walk the earth after the prophets. He was the man who was always first place in doing good. And those of us who have studied the seerah know that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was the first man to believe in the Prophet ﷺ's message. He was the one whose iman never wavered, not even for one second. The one who would put his own health and happiness before the Prophet ﷺ's every time. Well, after the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died in Medina, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq became Khalifa, meaning that now he was the leader of the Muslim Ummah. And Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, another very close companion of Rasulullah and of Abu Bakr, tells us a story. Every morning Abu Bakr led Fajr prayer. But one morning after Salah, I noticed Abu Bakr leaving the masjid and walking in the opposite direction of his house. He walked far away into the desert, away from the city. I noticed him doing this day after day, and every day I would wonder, where does he go? What does he do? My curiosity grew and grew until one day I decided to follow him and see. I saw Abu Bakr go into an old home, and I waited and waited for him to come out, but he spent a long time in there, way past sunrise, before finally leaving and making his way back to Medina. Umar al-Khattab says, I waited until Abu Bakr was far enough, then I approached the house and knocked on the door. The door was opened by a blind woman. She was very old and very weak, and there were children running around in the home, so I asked her, what is your situation, O Amatullah, O servant of Allah? She said, I am a blind woman with these orphans, and I'm all alone, and I have to take care of them. I asked, who is that visitor who comes to you every morning? She said, I do not know who he is. He never once told me his name. I asked, what does he do? She replied, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him. Every morning he comes to my home. He cleans it. He washes our clothes. He grinds our wheat. He cooks our breakfast, and then he leaves. Can you imagine the Khalifa of the Ummah, the most powerful man with the highest status of the time, doing this kind of work every day and remaining unknown and then going back to governing the Muslims? Can you imagine a president or a king going to an old woman's home and helping her clean up and make food for her children? Umar ibn Khattab asked her, he comes every single day? And she replied, every day. May Allah bless him. And he does not ask to be paid. When hearing this, Umar ibn Khattab cried. And he said, every Khalifa after you will be exhausted, O Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq had set such a high standard that nobody would be able to reach. This is just one secret of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq that was exposed, but who knows how many other secret good deeds he had that he was able to hide from everyone else. And this is a lesson for us about the importance of doing something between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that only He knows about. It's good to do some good deeds in public so we can encourage each other to do them, but we should also keep something special between ourselves and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that only He knows about. That way we know for sure that we aren't doing that action so people can say good things about us. We can be 100% sure that our intentions are sincere. We don't expect anything from anyone. No kind words, no monetary reward. We will know that our reward will come later on the Day of Judgment. And sometimes that will make the good deed we've done even sweeter. So the next time you do something good, shh, it's a secret. Assalamu alaikum. I hope to see you again soon. May all your pathways be pure.